In the previous video, I have shown the use of XPS database, smoothing of a spectrum, and energy calibration of an element. If you have not watched it, please check it now. The link is given in the description. Now, I will show a quantitative analysis of the XPS spectrum. Let's open it. In this spectrum, I will look for SiO2. I want to know the quantitative presence of silicon and oxygen. Ideally, the atomic percentage of oxygen should be 66.66, and for silicon, it should be 33.33. Let's find out how much percentage of each is present. Now, I will open XPS database. XPSSimplify.com. If you can remember, I have used this database in the previous video also. I am using it now to understand the most commonly observed core peaks of silicon and oxygen, so that I can easily identify them in my spectrum. Let's see silicon first. It can have three peaks. 2p3 halves, 2p½ and 1 indicating oxide. And these are between 95 and 105 electron volts. Now, let's look for them in our spectrum. Yes, these are the peaks we are looking for. I can confirm it once more. We can also confirm it from the elements library. This is the elements library. The smartness of this library is that if you click on a position of the spectrum, the library will rearrange itself to show the information around that position where you clicked. This one is 2p3 halves. Next, should be 2p½. Here we have difficulty to confirm the oxide peak. That's why you should use a standard database or reported figure. Next step is, create a region. Then name it. SI2P. Then enter. Adjust the region by simply dragging the sidebar. We need to create three components. First one, 2p3 halves. Create another component. (2p½). The position seems wrong. It must be 102.5. Let's enter it. The third one should be here, at 116.37. And it is the oxide peak. Let's fit these components. Not very bad. Let's do the same for oxygen peak. There are two peaks, almost overlapping. And these are around 532. Let's create a region for oxygen peaks. Adjusting the region. Name it O1S. Create the first component, O1S. Interesting, here we don't need a second one. Correcting the range of the region may improve the fitting. Fit again. Let's see the result. To display the result, go to Annotation. Then, Quantification. Choose Components or Regions. These are the atomic percentages for each component. Let's see the ratio for regions. I have to delete one. To delete, go to annotation history. Select and delete the one you don't want. And here is the result. The ideal was 33.33 and 66.66. We got around 34.5 and 65.5. Well, it's not bad, for very initial try. However, this can be improved. In the next videos, I will try to show how this can be improved. Stay tuned. See you in the next.